I just want to talk about another problem in the AIMO 2016 that I was trying to do as sort of a review of what techniques I need to know to do these kind of things. And I'm still kind of maybe in a different train of thought than the kind of style of thinking that's conducive to the exam. So the problem was something like this. You had 11 by 38 grid of squares, and you wanted to color some of them black and leave the rest white. And the rule was that you wrote in the white squares the number of black squares that it touches side by side. So it sh shares an edge. If it shares an edge with a black square, then you plus one to the total that you write in the middle. So, or something like this. There's a white square and it's surrounded by black squares. You'd write four. Yeah, if this was white, then you'd only write three. And then the question was, what's the maximum possible sum of all the numbers written in white squares? So out of all the possible configurations. Okay, so yeah, I managed to do this question in the time allotted. I couldn't quite. I guess I couldn't just quite find my rhythm in this problem. I think I made a nice observation at the beginning, but I guess I couldn't really use it to directly help me. But even though it obviously gave me good ways to guess it, what the answer should be. So one of the observations I made at the beginning was, it really doesn't matter that the numbers are written inside the white squares, that just might be a bit of a distraction. You could really actually write the numbers on the edges of a white and black square, because the only times you'll get contributions to that number are when you have a black and white square touching each other. And so I have a diagram here like this. So I'm trying to write this plus one on this edge. And so if you write them on the edges, then it'll be clear that there's a symmetry between the black and white squares. And so what I mean by and what I mean by that symmetry is that you could replace all the white squares by black squares, and then all the white. So switch the colors of all the squares. So have all the black ones turn white and the white ones turn black. And you should have another configuration that has the same sum of numbers. Okay, so it's a sum preserving symmetry. So I thought that was quite nice. And so if there was only one maximum, okay, then if there was only one configuration, so I'm not actually sure that there's only one configuration at this point, but if there was only one configuration for which the maximum was achieved, then it would have to be invariant under this symmetry of switching white and black squares. And I guess obviously it's not like fixed, but it could be invariant. When I say unique configuration, I guess it means it might look the same as the other configuration if I just like rotated the grid or something. And and something that sort of satisfies that property is a chessboard. Okay, so if you had a chessboard and you colored it black and white, and then you applied the process of switching black and white, you'll get Well, you won't get exactly the same chessboard, but if I think if you just kind of rotated 180 or something, it'll basically it will be the same. Okay. So that made me think of a chessboard, and then I calculated the. So then I calculated the numbers that would go into the chessboard. Okay. So the numbers that would fit in the chessboard, for example, it'd be a two here. It'd be a three here. And so if there was any time another corner, it'd be a two. Anytime there's an edge that's not a corner, there'd be a three, and then all the middle ones. Say four. Okay, maybe I have my piece of paper. Let me look for that. Okay, I can't quite find my other working for this, but I did actually get a number out of calculating these. And so the number turned out to be equal to 10 times 38 plus 11 times 37. Which I didn't actually notice. I actually just got the number that this was equal to. Okay, so this is equal to 380 plus 370 plus 37. So this is equal to 787. So I just had 787. I didn't realize it was actually equal to this. If I realized that, it would have been much easier because this corresponds to the number of interior edges inside of this grid. So, I mean, if that's the total number of edges and each one of them can be marked with a plus one, then that must be the maximum possible sum. Okay, so it would have been nice to realize that, but I didn't realize that at the time. And instead, I did some sort of if you have that in your mind, then what I'm gonna do is gonna sound pretty stupid, but I think it worked. So I tried to show that every time you have a 2x2 grid, you could always increase or maintain the sum by making it in this pattern, so two white and two black. Okay. So, one way you could consider that is what you could consider, if they're all black, or sorry, if they're all white, if they're all white, the numbers in them could all be at most two each. Okay. If they were two or one or something else, they'll be increased by making one of the squares black. And that's essentially because the white square is just really it's really just about the perimeter of the black shapes. Okay. And so when you make one of these squares black, it doesn't change the perimeter. And in some cases it lets you increase it because it lets you write the perimeter on a white square that you couldn't write it on before. And you wouldn't have to consider half of the cases because of the symmetry I was talking about. So you only really have to consider about the cases when it's all white or like three white, two white, and one white. And then you see that this pattern will always make whatever existing numbers you had bigger or equal. So if every 2x2 grid can be changed into two white and two black, then essentially the maximum must be obtained using the chessboard. That's basically what you show. Okay, and the disadvantage of this obviously is that it can be quite cumbersome to explain. And your explanation, like the one that's written down, might not be the rigorous one that's in your head. Okay, so while it worked, it might have been much nicer to say that the number of edges was given by this, and so therefore it was already the maximum.